The village of Windom was planted in 1871 by A.L. Beach, division engineer of the Sioux City and St. Paul Railroad. Plats for all towns up and down the railroad right-of-way were laid out the same as Windom, with a center square and businesses around it, but Windom was the only village who actually followed the plan. The first ordinance was passed by the council on April 15, 1875, and related to the selling and bartering of intoxicating liquors within the village. The Windom Police Department was officially formed in 1928 with the hiring of its first uniformed officer, John Long John Solem, on March 1, 1928. Records are sparse prior to 1928, but they do show at least one prior constable, Tom Hawkins, who was responsible for the law within the city of Windom. Chief Solem's nickname, Long John, came from his above-average height of 6'4" and his long, lanky build. It was mockingly said that he could walk the square at 4 paces. He was born 1890 to Mr. and Mrs. Thomas Solem and never married. He served in France in World War I, and after his discharge, he joined up with his friend and future sheriff Nick Bell to work out west as a carpenter. On June 8, 1925, President Calvin Coolidge spoke to an audience of over 80,000 Norwegian Americans at the Minnesota State Fairgrounds for the Norse American Centennial. John was selected to be a member of the honor guard for President Coolidge, the requirements being that he was over 6 feet tall and Norwegian. One of his proudest moments was in the 30s. A 100-man posse from Redwood County was formed to find a man accused of attempted murder of a young woman. Sheriff Bell told John to keep his eye out. Later that night, John found the man hiding in the boxcar with his long limbs. He pulled the man from the boxcar and promptly marched the man straight to Sheriff Bell's office without ever drawing his pistol. Prior to the invention of mobile radios, when there was a call for police services, either a special light was activated downtown, or the telephone operator would call the steam operator and have him blow the steam whistle once. In 1935, the city purchased its first police car. The squad car pulled double duty as the town taxi ferrying night hospital workers and anyone who didn't get picked up by the train. He gave many a GI ride home to their families. Even while he had access to the squad car, he spent the majority of his patrol time on foot checking each alley and street for nefarious behavior. In addition to his regular police duties arresting drunks and thieves, Chief Solem would check the business doors around 9 p.m., making sure that they were locked. Then around 11:30 p.m., he would stop by local restaurants where people had left letters for mailing. Depositing them in his satchel, he would take the mail to the depot and sort it for mailing. Chief Solem was the sole law enforcement officer in Windom until 1948 when he hired Bob Still. He worked as chief of police for 29 years when he retired in 1956 as the legendary Long John Solem. After Solem retired, Bob Still became chief in 1956, followed by George Letourneau in 1963. Chet Barstad in 1967 and then Don Olson in 1970. During this era, the police department has housed in an office in City Hall. The department had 2 squad cars for use on patrol, but the second car was the personal vehicle of the chief. The other officers of this era included Larry Bell, Howard Horkey, Wally Bueller, Jim Donahue, and Richard Thompson. This photo shows rookie officer Merrill Bush earning his badge when the department expanded to a force of 6. Wally Bueller recalls that his wage was $230 a month with a $3 a month uniform allowance. He now jokes that it took him 6 months to earn a new pair of pants. Officers typically worked long stretches of days with no overtime. During one stretch, Bueller said he worked 108 straight night shifts with a few weeks off in between, and then worked another 87 night shifts in a row. The officers led by Bueller's initiative eventually demanded that the city hall give them overtime, which the city finally granted for all police staff and all city employees. In the mid-1970s, the police department moved to its new addition in the sheriff's office, and Elton Wagner took the department reins in 1973. This photo taken in 1987 shows Kevin Patterson, Jim White, Secretary Deb Nesseth, Al Wagner, Jim Donahue, Robert Shoemaker, Bruce Toninato, and Jeff Shirky in front of the new police station. 1997, Chief Gary Johnson came to the department as chief for the next 4 years and was succeeded by longtime officer Jeff Shirkey. In 2012, we currently have 8 full-time officers, including a sergeant and a new chief, Scott Peterson. He's from Iowa, but we really don't hold that against him. All in all, the department has employed 37 full-time uniformed officers and 9 chiefs since 1928. The technology and training have come a long way in the past 84 years, but one thing has stayed the same. Police officers' first rule, be alert. John Solomon's words in 1956 still ring true today. You drive around and watch and keep your eyes open, but they can see you too. If you knew where they were going to be, you'd be there waiting. But you can only be at one place at one time, so always be alert.